सॉल्यूशन ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 38. इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव अ सेकंड ऑर्डर होमोजेनियस लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड गिवन वाई वन एंड वाई टू इट्स टू सॉल्यूशंस. इनफैक्ट दे आर द फंडामेंटल सेट ऑफ सॉल्यूशन फॉर दिस डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. हियर फंडामेंटल सेट ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस मीन्स द वर्किंगसंस ऑफ वाई वन एंड वाई टू कैन नॉट बी जीरो इन द गिवन डोमेन. हियर वी हैव डोमेन क्लोज इंटरवल ए कोमा बी वेर ए एंड बी कैन एनी रियल नंबर्स. ओके, नाउ द वर्किंगसन ऑफ वाई वन एंड वाई टू गिवन एज वाई वन वाई टू डैश माइनस वाई टू वाई वन डैश. ओके, नाउ ऑल्सो वी हैव एक्स नॉट बी ए पॉइंट इन द गिवन डोमेन. Now we have to check the given options, that is options A, B, C and D. In the option A, we have both y1 and y2 cannot have a local maximum at x equal to x0. Yes, so it is correct because if y1, y2 have a local maximum at x equal to x0, then y1 dash and y2 dash both going to be 0 at x equal to x0. In that case, the working sum of y1, y2 also going to be 0. So this cannot be happened na, because y1 and y2 are the fundamental set of solutions. So our option A is correct. Now similarly in the option B we have y1 and y2 cannot have a local minimum at x equal to x0. So this option is also correct because if y1 and y2 have a local minimum at x equal to x0, then y1 dash y2 dash both going to be 0 at x equal to x0. Then our working sum also going to be 0. And this cannot be happened, same as y1, y2 form a fundamental set of solutions. So option B is correct. Now in the option C, we have y1 cannot have a local maximum at x equal to x0 and y2 cannot have a local minimum at x equal to x0. So it is also correct, same as above options, because y1, if y1 has local maximum at x equal to x0, then y1 dash at x0 0, and if y2 have local minimum at x equal to x0, then y2 dash at x0 going to be 0, then working sum going to be 0. So this we don't want because y1, y2 fundamental set of solutions. So option C is also correct. And in the option D we have y1 and y2 cannot vanish at x equal to x0 simultaneously. Yes, it is also correct because if y1 and y2 both going to be 0 at x equal to x0, then also our working sum going to be 0. That's why our option D is also correct. So the thing is, given all the options A, B, C and D are correct for the given differential equations. Solution of question number 50. Here we have T be a linear transformation from R2 to R2 and here R2 be a vector space of dimension 2. And also we have three vectors V1, V2, V3 of R2. So if we take any two vectors among these three vectors, they will form a basis for R2. And also we have that map defined as T at V1 is equal to V2, T at V2 equal to V3 and T at V3 is equal to V1. Now we have to find how many such linear transformations are going to be exist. Okay, so for that we have to find such linear transformation. Since here T is the map from R2 to R2 and defined by like that as given in the question. So to evaluate T, firstly we have to write down any vector x, y as a linear combination of basis of R2. As I told, if we take any two vectors among V1, V2, V3, then they will form a basis for R2 space. So since here we have three vectors, so we have three combinations. In fact, such combinations, those form a basis for R2. Okay, like that. If we take V1, V2, they're going to be basis. Or if we take V2, V3, they're going to be a basis. Or if we take V3, V1, then they're going to be a basis. So corresponding to these three set of basis, we can find out three linear transformations. Those are satisfying the given property. So here, three is our answer. Solution of question number 56. Here we have a series of positive terms and we have to find its sum. Okay. Now we know to evaluate its sum. Firstly, we have to fractionate partially its nth term. Here we have nth term, that is un equal to 1 upon 2n minus 1 times 2n plus 1. So when we fractionate this, then we have un equal to half times 1 upon 2n minus 1 minus 1 upon 2n plus 1. Okay, now to evaluate the sum of the given series, we'll use sequence of partial sum. Here sequence of partial sum is nothing but sum of the first n terms of the series. So when we take first n sum of the first n term of the series, then we have this expression given in the solution, and when we evaluate this, so at the last we have Sn is equal to half time 1 minus 1 upon 2n plus 1. So when we evaluate the limit of this sequence of partial sum, that is the limit of Sn, then we have the value of limit is equal to half. And we know the limit of sequence of partial sum, if it is exists, then this limit is nothing but sum of the series. So here the sum of the series is nothing but half. So half is our answer.